The last time I met Anushka Sharma, she was too superstitious to even voice the wish list of directors that she wanted to work like that. With. But since then, systematically, main opening kar rahi hu, 1 minute chup rahe. Systematically, since then, she has worked with her entire wish list of amazing directors. You might as well list them now, now that you don't want me to do my opening. Vishal Bhardwaj, Raju Hirani, Yash Chopra, Adi, of course, you'd already worked with, Karan Johar, Anurag Kashyap.
Yeah.
So your wish list is kind of complete, right?
Not complete. I'm adding more names to it.
Okay, more names. Now I'm carrying on with my opening. And in spite of dating one of the hottest cricket gods of this country, she has managed to keep a very low profile compared to her contemporaries. She's also been accused of having all of North India's bubbliness inside her. So I cannot wait to unleash that. Although I didn't need to wait, she's already like started off. Now tell me this, that in PK you're playing a journalist. Mm. If you had to ask the actress Anushka the question that's going to make you a hero, right, back in the office, because you've just got like a question that no one's asked, what would it be?
I wouldn't ask her. So distracted by this couch.
Don't even try, okay? You're not being Anushka the actress, you're being Anushka the journalist.
But it's really soft.
You know, every time you don't answer me, I have a bat here. Every time you don't answer, actually, here's the bat. Please, someone throw the ball. Let's see how good your shot is.
Overhand, we bolte hain.
Yay! Not bad. Not bad. You're also shocked, huh? Well, I
not really. I was very worried about your cameraman.
Okay, moving on from there. Fine, since you're not answering that question. So there are obviously things that you don't want revealed, right? That you're holding on to quite tightly. There are questions that you could ask yourself.
But Koel, honestly, I mean, if you look at it, I don't really hide anything. It's just that I'm not comfortable speaking about a lot of things. I mean, I think what a journalist would like to know about me at the moment would probably be about this guy behind there, right? But, and I know that, but I don't wish to speak about it because what can be done with that information when you start to speak? I mean, it's very normal. I mean, I'm someone who's living my life very openly, and you know, it's what's there is there for people to see. But when I start speaking about it, when I start to begin to talk about my personal life, even if it's like something like, oh, this is, you know, how we met, then I'm somewhere then putting myself in a position where I can be asked anything about my personal life for how many ever years to come. The first time I did an interview and I was asked about it, I spoke about it. And I said exactly what I'm telling you right now.
But so no one, basically because you didn't say, I am seeing Virat Kohli and I am his girlfriend, people are like, nee, you're denying it. That was the idea.
Which is pretty silly, right? Because I mean, you're seeing what is there and I'm
like, you've got to be stupid, right?
So I found it damn weird and I found it very stupid. Mm. And they still continue asking me the same thing again and again, which I think is just...
So leave it for a second. Let's talk about you as an actress. Now I'm going to come to one of my favorite bikini, or I would actually call it sportskini, right? It's more like a sportskini shot of yours, right? Yeah. This is, and it's from every angle, it's the most beautifully photographed bikini shot. You have one of the most flawless bodies, right? But everyone else, like yourself, you can see your flaws and you kind of cringe at yourself. Are you super confident and you have no confidence issues?
No, not about my body, etc. I just cringe when I see myself on screen, like performing or saying dialogues, being emotional or all that. Then I'm like, what am I doing? Like that's
when
it happens.
But to convince you to take your clothes off is the easy part.
It sounds so
horrible. I mean like this. I don't mean it, please. Like, I don't mean like take, like, you know, but to
I mean, if it makes sense and why am I doing it? Then it's if there's a logic to it, if I know why it's happening, then obviously it doesn't take.
Because we live in a, you live in an industry where there's so much pressure to be attractive, and it's a major part of what you do, right? And right in the beginning, your bubble was burst because you told me that Adi told you you're not the most pretty girl. Yeah. So, you know, don't even think that you are. But do you then feel the pressure suddenly to be more glamorous, more stunning? Is that what that whole lip enhancement thing was part of?
No, you know what, people don't understand. If that's why it happened, then I would be doing those kind of films also, na Koel, but I'm not doing those kind of films. Hmm. It's not like I can't do those kind of films, but I'm not doing those kind of films. I just have to be glamorous and looking beautiful. Similarly, the lip thing was for Bombay Velvet, which people obviously haven't seen anything of right now. And that's the reason why I did it.
So because you got such bad press for it and such bad reaction for it, are you worried that people may not like that look in now that it's gone down, right? So it's fine, but what if they don't like it in Bombay Velvet the way they reacted to you?
No, I'm not thinking that. Because see, I'm telling you, I'm usually very sure of, you know, why I do what I do. I just don't like talking and explaining myself too much because I like my work to speak for itself. But then, even then, if people see the film and they think differently from what I thought, that's also fine.
You live and learn.
Not because I want to live and learn. I'm very sure of why I did what I did. Because I knew that this was going to, this would help me with what I was doing. I'm a jazz singer. You know, there's this whole, like,
you want the lips,
the whole, like, you sing. So I thought it would help me.
You got trolled like hell. What was the most amusing or the most obnoxious thing that, you know, because you were quite shocked by how you got trolled for something so silly. Like, I think it's your face. You can do whatever the hell you want. If you can't do it to your own self, who can you do it to?
The thing is, I was out of town when this happened. So I knew that something was going on, but I didn't know the extent to which people were speaking about it. So when I came back to Bombay, like my publicist, like, you know, she's like, have you checked yourself on Twitter? I said, no, I know something's happening. She's like, no, I think you should just go and like have a look. And then I saw it. And then I was like, how can people be so nasty, you know, like,
so tell me one of the funny nasty ones. We don't want to get into the hurtful ones, but tell me something that you remember which you were like, really? Like,
the funny ones were the pictures that they would do. Those memes, what are they called?
It's meme.
The
bay.
Memes, yeah. So memes, one of those were really memes. Funny because they had the picture of the Joker and me. I thought that was damn funny.
But, so you have a sense of humor about it, right?
There is no other way of dealing with such things.
Of such things. Okay, now what we're going to do, I'm going to give you these dialogues. These are dialogues from your own film. I hope this is the right one. These are dialogues from your own film. And I have a copy of this. I'm going to ask you, you're going to first say the dialogue, and I'm going to ask you if it actually, from the character, does it have anything to do with Anushka the person? You know, how does it kind of... So will you say the first dialogue?
Dunya mein pyar se zyada dard kuch nahi hota.
Have you ever felt this? And
yeah, I think so. Because it's very personal. You know, professionally, everything, it's just, it's still something that you can take yourself out of. But when something's so personal and you invite someone into your life or, you know, whatever, then I think that's quite painful.
And what's your quick fix for that? Is there a quick fix for it?
No, you just have to let time heal it, yeah.
Okay, next.
Business ka first rule, jiske saath vyapar karo, usse kabhi na pyar karo.
This though you've broken. Yeah. No, you have broken,
I agree.
Right?
I agree to this.
But you have broken it. Now you are going to... Last boyfriend.
Who?
Ranveer. Acha, not boyfriend.
He was never my boyfriend.
Okay, we're going with that. Okay, fine. Next one.
Pehle sex hota hai, phir sochte hai ki love hai ki nahi. Haan, in a lot of cases.
Love it.
That is true. I mean, I'm
because
not
it's always lust first.
I'm not talking about myself. I mean, let's make that very, very clear.
It could also be.
No, I obviously believe in like sex after marriage.
One second. Just for that answer.
Do you want me to hit a shot?
Yes, just for that answer. Ball peko. Because that answer was completely utter nonsense and rubbish.
See? If it was true. If it was. If... That was one of the other things that I read on Twitter.
Out on duck, right?
Duck.
Yeah.
For my face.
Oh!
Quack, quack, Donald quack. Duck and all that. Some shit like that.
That's funny.
Young who, entertaining who, sexy who. Actually, tumhara to jackpot who. Limited offer hai, soch lo.
You think of yourself like this a bit, no? You do. Or not?
No.
No?
No. Young who, entertaining who, sexy.
You are young.
Actually, tomorrow, I think this is my alter ego.
Oh.
Yeah. And I'd like to say such things, but no. Pata chal gaya ki hai, mujhe Meena Kumari complex hai, haan.
Hai?
Us samay to definitely tha.
You are a big tragedy queen.
Matlab, I used to be, not now, but at like, around that time, I used to, and so I used to say ki tera to ye, this is, you're very well cast for this film, because I used to be like that. I used to feel like, you know, the sadness has to be, I'm happy, has to like romanticize sadness. I think that's something that everybody goes through, but not anymore. Now I hate drama.
Simplicity.
I can't deal with like dramatic situations or, people, or if people are trying to create drama in my life, I'm like, please just kindly leave. Like,
What does it mean for you, love? Because it's not a waste of time for you, right?
No, I think in the film it's just described as a concept, as another definition of love.
But since we're not allowed to talk about the film at all...
Practically it is, actually. Think about it, like, practically it is a waste of time. I mean, you're just like spending like... But also when you're younger, I think, you know, talking on the phone, the battery dies. When you're
no, it's a waste of time at any point. You know, even here, like, you're thinking, love, it's a real waste of time. But what do you do? Your whole world revolves around love. Who's, what do you do?
Whose?
Anyone's.
No. I don't think so. I think it should be a part of your life. It shouldn't be your life. It should be a part of your life. I think for me, love is companionship.
Mm-hmm.
With somebody I can respect, most importantly. Someone self-assured. Someone who, you know, who I enjoy spending time with. I don't like excess of anything in my life. So it always has to be a balance, you know, of things.
So what kind of girlfriend are you? Are you one of those...
I'm not talking about what kind of a girlfriend I am.
No, we're not talking about...
No, I'm not talking in general what kind of a girlfriend I am.
Okay, what kind of person are you? Are you in a relationship with friends, boyfriends, whatever? Could you give space? Are you one of those, like, I need space, you need space, and I'm cool? Or are you the possessive, chipkoo?
In fact, I'm not like that with in a relationship or even with my friends. Like, you know, there are people... Like, even now, I see some people who are my age... friends of friends, and they get irritated if, you know, their friends are getting closer to someone else. They're not even like in a relationship with them, but that starts to bother them, and I find that so silly. Like, I didn't even do that when I was in high school.
This so is what's not important then in a relationship,
understanding, absolutely, loyalty,
fidelity,
of course. In fact, I feel that when you have loyal friends, that's when you can be this way, you know, that's when you can feel this way, because otherwise, I mean, I would not invite people into my life, like, if I think they're, like I said, one of my first criteria was someone who's self-assured in a relationship. Similarly with like friends, for me, that's very important.
Because I feel like
somewhere, like, I think I'm not always looking for validation of any kind from people I'm looking for that when I'm working with, like, I'll drive my directors insane. Like, are you sure the shot is okay? Are you sure the shot is okay? I'll feel that way. But my personal life, no, I don't like that. I like things very simple.
So on set, now you just gave us a little glimpse of this. There's you who's OCD and going, I want to do it again, I want to do it again, and perfectionist. Then there's, of course, Mr. Perfectionist, Amir. And then there's Raju Hirani, which most people don't know, who's another... completely crazy, needs to know every frame, every shot. So give us a glimpse of what it was like.
It was a very normal world for us.
It's like, you guys just like
so normal.
Like, we just connect.
Yeah, this
right?
is so normal. Like, this is like, because these are very, very people are very who know what they're doing. And if you're having, these come from like really like, you know, like I'm saying, these come from these strange mindsets. These people that I was working with are ones who know what they're doing, what they want. And if they're listening to you, or if they're telling you something, it's in the larger interest of things. It's not like, meri tu sun, kyunki, you know, I want to like boss you around and let's show you who's boss. I mean, it's not coming from there. I have seen people like that.
No,
this set was not like that.
But most creative people, you can have an idea and he can
no,
have
and
an
you can
idea.
Fight. And you can fight.
Fight. So that's what I'm interested in.
Yeah.
Like, and you can lose and be bitter about it, you know?
But to someone looking from outside, it might seem like, oh, shit, they are fighting. But that's not what it is. It's just, you know, you get so passionate when you're discussing a scene, or, you know, you have an opinion of what you do, because, you know, that's what happens with Sir is that you can't it's very measured. He's not like, we will see. He's not that kind of a person. So if he's taken you, he knows that she will be able to deliver, she will be able to be Jagat Janani for me in this film. After that, if you can, over and above that, you can do something and you can make it its own, that's when he...
So what did you do with it that you actually got his praise for something?
Well, it was something to do with a scene, and he, you know, I performed it or whatever, and then I went and he said it was really nice and stuff. But I mean, that was, you know, that you feel like directors just say that. But then he called me in the night after.
You know, you think everyone just says.
Yeah,
everything is like they just say.
But I'm
like,
I'm a Taurian. I always think that people are just saying nice things to me just because they're saying nice things to me. I'm like, I'm telling him, sir, you're just like encouraging me. He's like, Anushka, this is like the second last day of shoot. Okay, I don't need to encourage you now. If I wanted to, if I was like, oh my God, if I say this to her right now, maybe she'll be better on sets the following days. That's not what's happening. So learn to take compliments. Vishal Bhardwaj told me, after I saw something on the monitor, I'm like, I'm cringing, and I'm like, so are you sure it's okay? Like, aisa to nahi lag raha ki main, you know, waisa kar rahi hu jaisa nahi lagna chahiye, blah, 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 blah. And I'm going on like pestering him. And he's like, हाँ हाँ मेरे को तो बहुत शौक है कि मैं अपने सारे गंदे टेक्स को हाँ बोलूँ, मुझे तो गंदी पिक्चरें बनानी है, मेरा तो यही मकसद है. So,
okay, so we're gonna take some tweets now, okay?
Tweets!
Yeah, tweets. Lot of tweets. At Aru Loves Anu says, ask her to sing a bit of Char Kadam.
Oh God. I thought I was a very good singer.
Yeah.
And then like I see like Priyanka singing and Alia singing and all, and now I'm like
Avchadi. Yeah, but that, listen, that's in the studio. A lot of things can be corrected. We'll also correct you.
No, but they've sung it live also. Bin puche mera naam aur pata, rasmo karke pare. Char kadam bas char kadam, chal do na saath mere. Bas.
Very nice song it is. Next one. Sabha Sanatic wants to know, please ask her to do those steps that she and Amir are doing for the Nanga Punga Dost video. Can you teach it to me actually? Because we're supposed to have couching classes and I didn't do anything with you.
Couching classes?
Yeah, couching classes.
What do you do in those couching classes?
People teach me different things.
I know, but I'm not doing it alone. You come
okay,
with me.
Come on, I'll do it with you. But I'm a terrible dancer, so you have to teach me, like break it down for me.
Okay, chalo.
And she's so tall. We're not going to fit in the same frame only.
Are we?
Are we fitting? Yes, all good.
Okay, chalo.
Oh, that's it.
Ding, ding.
Oh.
Ding, ding.
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 Ding, ding. Good enough, no?
Very good. Huh? Thank you. We'll put the music on top also.
Yeah.
Okay, but, so
here also, you don't want to use my voice. Thank you. Thank you very much. I get it.
Okay.
I want to light the candle.
Many people, so I'm not saying the name of all the tweets that were sent. Many people want to know if you're going to Australia to cheer Virat.
Of course, I would want to go. I would want to, not to cheer, I just want to go to, like, you know, be there. But I might not.
Not to cheer. I'll go to Australia and
I refuse to cheer.
And the boyfriend will be playing, you know, he's going to be captain, and you're going to go to Australia and not watch the match.
Because
you're just going to take a
holiday. Because I don't know whether I'll be able to go. So like, I don't want to say this.
Then
I'll only be answering these questions, Koel. You said on Koel's show that you're going to be watching. So which game are you going for? So let's just see if it happens, and it happens.
Okay. Coming back to her acting career. Raju Hirani is no doubt one of the most fantastic directors that you have, one of the most fantastic directors you have worked with. What is the one thing that you would like to tweak about his personality and his direction? Obviously,
his personality?
Yeah. And his direction,
so,
if at all.
I'm a bit anxious. So I keep like, you know, sometimes like if I'm thinking, I'm like constantly like doing this, like some kind of a
sick,
like something that I, just like some pattern that I get used to, and I keep doing that. And I start getting conscious of that because other people are going to notice that when I'm doing it. And then I start shooting with Raju Hirani, who's doing like, when he's talking like, or he's like, his hands are behind that, and he's like going on doing that. And I saw that and I was so happy. I was like, sir, are you a bit anxious? And then he, kyu? I said, I think you are.
And his face is so like relaxed and,
yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah. But I wouldn't want to change that about him, because that's what's like, that's what I mean.
That's a reflection of you. You saw you in.
Yeah.
Him.
I was like, okay, so it's. I was like, maybe even I'm coming across calm to people.
No. Oh damn it.
No.
No chance.
I would change. Yeah. Are you mad? You want to really change anything about Raju Hirani? As a director, no. Even as a person, no. He's the most genuine person I've met in the industry.
One thing you would like to imbibe, or and tweak about the following people. Okay, Aamir Khan.
His concentration is on another level. With Aamir, I think that's something that I would like to, because sometimes I can, you know, get distracted. And what would I like to change? Sometimes he takes a lot of, like he's talking and suddenly he like pause and he's thinking. And because he's Aamir Khan, like I start getting like, all like nervous. So like, I would change that.
Ranbir Kapoor.
What do I like about Ranbir Kapoor? I like the choices he makes with his films. What would I like to tweak about him if he would just stop asking so many questions? Like he's constantly like, he start talking to you and he'll know everything about you, like where you went, what you were doing, everything. And he'll continue probing and questioning, and after a while you just feel like you just did a chat show with him, like you know. And at the end it's like you're like, What the hell just happened? Like, what was that conversation even?
So if ever his career, which it doesn't look like it's going, if it ever takes a sort of plateau, he has a perfect career.
He will be superb.
So I hope he doesn't, okay? So yeah. Taking my job away. Virat Kohli.
What do I like about Virat Kohli?
It's not the like, it's the imbibe. Like, you know, a bit
what
that
would
you
I imbibe?
Would, yeah, like you would take that personality trait on or be happy to.
I think he's very sensitive, like very as a person, very sensitive, like very aware of like people and like, you know,
emotions and
yeah, very nice, like that. What would I change about him? He's always like in a, like he can't just be, like he needs to know what he's doing. The next, what he's doing next after that, and what he's going to do after that. Like so, there's like, so he just can't be. So like, I just wanted to kind of just. Not just be, sometimes.
Yeah. Come to Australia and not play cricket.
No. Just be. Thanks a lot, huh? For like
twisting it around.
Yeah. Fully. Thanks a lot.
But I'm going to edit everything out.
Only about batting. What is this?
I'm going to edit everything out and make you sound like Virat Kohli. I'm not going to change anything about your personality. Like, I'll just edit it and put it all in like, you know, what you've taken about.
See,
what you're actually saying
see,
about Raju Hirani, I'm going to put there. That's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah. I think that's what you're going to do. Yeah.
Okay. So on that note, I'm going to say bye. Maybe next time you'll be the. Do you want to wear the crown?
Ranveer wore it.
No, he didn't. That was
just
putting
your
leg. Yeah. No, I was putting. It's the couch's crown. You can wear it. Come, I'm going to give you the.
No,
crown.
But actually,
just for just. It's not Ranveer didn't wear it. Ali Zafar wore it.
Oh, he did.
Yeah. Who I think.
I like Ali Zafar.
Who doesn't?
Thanks.
Thanks. Can you give your little speech? Your glamour girl speech.
I really like your cameraman. He's nice.